I always wanted to be a missionary, but my parents were my first mission field. In 2011, I believe, or 2010, that's when I started going to my home country first, Philippines. I'm a nurse by profession. And that's one thing also because God has called me into nursing. And as God called me, He funded my nursing education. So I felt that it's time to give back, yeah. But so through all the years, for about 7 years now, God purified my motives. I got healed in the process. It's no longer a performance service to the Lord, but it's partnering with Him, partnering in His work.
Helen asked me earlier if I wanted to go to Colombia. I said, oh no. That was the farthest thing from my mind. Last day of the mission conference, the Lord, early in the morning, the Lord tells me, I want you to go to Colombia with Helen. And that's where it all started. And I asked questions, what am I going to do there? Because I'm not a nurse, I'm not anything, I don't know anything medical. But He says, I'm going to take His light and shine it over there. And He says, don't be afraid. I will walk with you all the way. And that's what He did. And so that just, my fears just went. Because, you know, you trust in the Lord and He will take care of you. I didn't know what was going to happen. I was kind of like, okay, this is a brand new venture. And I was just ready. Whatever it was, I was ready. Put me any place. I don't care. But He also told me, because I'm going and I'm obedient and faithful, many will be blessed. Not only over there in Colombia, but also I will bring the blessing back home. And we just cannot miss out on blessings.
So Vela Vista is a transformed prison.
What does that
mean? Meaning that in the mid-1980s, there was a revival exploded in that prison. And even before that, missionaries have been trying to minister in Bella Vista. But from 1980s, when there was about a riot to explode, there was this chaplain that just prayed and gathered all the prisoners, and they all laid down their arms and prayed, because the Colombian government was ready to bring the military to just squelch this riot. But from there on, there was just transformation of the prisoners. I mean, there is even a Bible school now in that prison. And it was just amazing. I mean, just imagine, that prison is the worst, the bloodiest prison in the world before 1980s, you know, wherein a lot of decapitated heads are even used for soccer balls. You know, there was always a murder every day in that prison.
So when we went to the prison, it was good in the beginning. It's like, you know, one or two people at a time, and everybody's praying. Then the lines got longer. Our head prayer lady, she had six people she was praying for. And then, so my partner and I were praying for four people. And so we're just praying, you know. So I'm praying for this one guy, and I'm touching him. I have my hand on him. Then I said, oh, I think he's going, he's getting kind of wobbly here. I put my hand in the back. He's slain in the spirit. And so he goes down, and I go down on top of him. And everybody's like, okay. But I had, you know, other prayer warriors, you know, watching me. But we have no catchers. And we're on our own. I did my best, but he was just too strong. And I was like, Lord, you did that. I said, you used me, I said, I was just blown away, because it's like, I only know prophets who do that.
That's never happened to you before?
Never. I wouldn't imagine anything like that could happen to me. But after praying for him, I said, well, I continued on. I prayed, and you know, the people in the prison, they changed my heart. Mm-hmm. As much as, you know, how bad they did, they were in there for something, doing something bad, I said, I could feel for them. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, everybody makes mistakes, and they're still God's children. Mm-hmm. And so it's like, you know, the ones that really appreciate prayer, they come up and they hug you. Mm-hmm. And that's all. That's what it is. But, you know, when they receive Christ, you got to look at their faces. Mm-hmm. They're so happy. And that's what it's all about.
This is His work. I was there to partner with God. I don't have any agenda. It's just that I want to see what You're doing, Lord. And just partnering with the Holy Spirit, it just makes me really that I've done what He has called me to do.